What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. You know, the My Hero Academia show is pretty popular, even more now with season 4 out, you know, of the anime right now and still going on. So you know what comes right after a popular anime, though? It's a popular video game. We've only seen one My Hero Academia game so far, and for what it's worth, it could be a little bit better. The first time I played it, I thought to myself, like, I kind of just wasted $65 and space on my PlayStation. But after a while, I thought to myself, it could be a better game if it was expanded on more and completely different. So today, I will propose my idea of a good or at least decent My Hero Academia game. Alright. First point, the character creation. So, one of the things I would love to have in a My Hero Academia game is character creation. Also, nope, I'm going to be taking elements from some other games with character customization too, so, you know, and continue on back with the actual script. Imagine you can create, like, a character in My Hero Academia. That would be super cool. Anyway, you are welcome into the world of My Hero Academia right at episode 1 of the show. You get to choose what type of quirk you want. There are 3 different types of quirks in My Hero Academia, and I'm going to go over them really quickly with you guys if you don't know. And they are as follows: Mutant, Emitter, and Transformation. So mutant type quirks are quirks that you can't turn off and that are very physical quirks. So people like Shoji, you know, with his tail, with his like Dupla arms, Jiro with her earphone jacks, and Toru with her invisibility. Emitter type quirks are quirks that are very flashy, and you know, and you see quirks like that with characters like Uraraka, Deku, and Bakugo. And transformation type quirks are quirks that can temporarily change the person and or give them some kind of alteration. Example of these quirks are people like Tetsu, Kirishima, and Mount Lady. So, you get to choose from a wide variety of each one of those quirks falls under one of those 3 categories. You can read a description for each one of them, and it tells you the power and the drawback for them, depending on the type of quirk that you have. And once you choose that, and you fiddle around with how you want your character to look, you know, the hair, the body type, etc., then you start the actual game, which is then my next point, the story and the choices in the story. So you start off trying to get your character into UA High, wanting to become a hero, as you know everyone usually does. You hear what All Might did, you know, earlier that day with the sludge villain, and you are now heading home, reading about it on your phone. You run into Deku, have a short conversation, until you decide to go home, you know, for dinner and stuff like that. Once you get home, you have the option to train for 10 months to increase the power of the quirk that you chose, depending on what type of quirk it is, or you can skip that time and continue with the story. Either way, right, you have to take the entrance exam, fighting tons of robots like they did in the first episode. You need a total of at least 50 points to pass, and you get about 5 minutes to get those 50 points. You pass, and you get inside Class 1A. You meet the cast, you know, Deku, Bakugo, Uraraka, Ida, and everyone else. And, you know, after that, then you go through the story of My Hero Academia like normal. But a few things are different only because you are there. Everything is still the way it is up until the USJ arc, where you meet the League of Villains. So, after, you know, the League of Villains do their introduction or whatever, you get separated from everyone else, and you're now all on your own. But you are near Eraserhead, so, you know, just a little bit away from him. But you end up fighting a few of the villains, and then you start, and now you're fighting Tomura Shigaraki. Because, you know, again, you were teleported near Eraserhead, but he's busy and he can't get to you right now, so you have to fight him on your own. After your fight with Shigaraki, you get pinned down by the Nomu, and he offers you a choice: to join the League of Villains or die. So, you get the choice of becoming a villain at that point in the story. And you have to start over, and you know, you will now live a very villainous life. But anyway, you get many choices like this throughout the course of the game to become either a hero and or a villain, and it all depends on your choices. Or maybe it could be at the start of the game. That's a quick side note. You know, it all depends on what you want and how everything develops. But part three, though, and this is gameplay and graphics. So the game will look a little bit similar to My Hero's One Justice game, but it would be a bit, just a little bit different, because I wouldn't want to keep the art style the same way. If you ever heard of Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4, then you would kind of know how I would want it to look. But it would have to merge the two graphic styles and make it kind of a balance. So anyway, because it would have to be a nice balance between anime and video game, and Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 4 does a great job of doing that. Like, if you didn't see the way, like, if you didn't watch Naruto and you only played the games, then and just cut out all the parts of actual gameplay and just looked at all the cutscenes, it would look like basically like a regular anime, just, you know, like 3D. But the way it will look would be a mix of My Hero's One Justice and the way Naruto looks. But anyway, and the actual combat, you know, the fighting in the game, I will want it to be more the way Naruto is, only because the way Naruto is, it feels more of a flow. It's kind of hard to explain, but basically the game feels more kind of like second nature in a way, if you get what I mean. But that's besides the point. You will get to explore more of the world of My Hero Academia, because the game will allow you to free roam. You'll get to explore Hosu City. You would also get to get the option to go train and improve your quirk. You also get to do like little side quests and things like that, and you know, little missions if that's what you're into, and you know, things like that. Also, if you go down the hero path, right, you will have to randomly stop minor villains from little things like, you know, robbery and stuff like that. And as you go on in the game, as you progress through, you know, the actual story, right, the crimes that they commit get tougher and tougher. And especially after you get your provisional license, though, it gets even worse. And if you choose to go down the villain path, you get to commit those actual crimes like robbery, hurting people or killing people, and you know, robbing banks, mugging, etc. Kind of like second nature in a way, if you get what I mean. But that's besides the point. You will get to explore more of the world of My Hero Academia, because the game will allow you to free roam. You'll get to explore Hosu City. You would also get to get the option to go train and improve your quirk. You also get to do like little side quests and things like that, and you know, little missions if that's what you're into, and you know, things like that. Also, if you go down the hero path, right, you will have to randomly stop minor villains from little things like, you know, robbery and stuff like that. And as you go on in the game, as you progress through, you know, the actual story, right, the crimes that they commit get tougher and tougher. And especially after you get your provisional license, though, it gets even worse. And if you choose to go down the villain path, you get to commit those actual crimes like robbery, hurting people and or killing people, and you know, robbing banks, mugging, etc. And the things that you do, you know, like the committing the crimes, will become tougher as you progress through the story, right? Because basically you get a time limit before the pro heroes show up for you to commit your crime and etc. But you do have the option of actually waiting for the time to go down for you to fight the pro heroes and still do your crime, or you know, you just do your crime and get out of there, if you get what I mean. And as you go through the game, the time limit for the pro heroes to respond on the scene actually gets smaller and smaller. So let's say, for example, you're trying to mug some elderly woman or whatever, right? And of course, she would have a quirk, so you would have to kind of fight her in a way. And after a certain point, you know,
you will get like, let's say you get like 5 minutes to, you know, mug and fight, right? And as you progress through the story, like later on, like after a certain point, then you'll get like 3 minutes or 2 minutes or whatever, you know, the amount of time would be. But, you know, other than that, right, if you lose, you know, you go to jail, and essentially, then, you know, the villains or someone will probably have to bust you out, or that could be game over, or you bust yourself out. Depends, I haven't really thought about that too much. But anyway, you can also explore the world to your heart's content, you know, just running around the city, just looking at the sights, maybe going to a store, buying, you know, items and things like that, and, you know, just have fun with the actual game, because that's what you want to do. It's a My Hero Academia game, of course you want to have fun. And that brings me to my next point, which is other mode and gameplay features. Of course, you have to have gameplay features, you know, and those gameplay features will be, you know, versus matches, online matches, a gallery so, you know, you can look at cutscenes or learn more about the characters and stuff like that, an arcade mode, story slash adventure mode, and maybe a mission mode. I'm not too sure about that, because, anyway. And, you know, stuff. I know I didn't go in depth as much as I would have wanted to, but this is a YouTube video, and I've been talking for way too long as it stands. So, like, comment, and subscribe. Tell me what you think in the comments below, and also pitch your own ideas. I'd love to hear them. Anyway, I'll see you next time in another video, and see you guys. Also, again, tell me what, you know, what kind of My Hero Academia game you will want to make in the comment section below. And don't forget, again, to like and subscribe. See ya. Oh, and real quick, if you have any other ideas of, you know, stuff like this for, like, these types of videos, you know, just leave an idea for the comment in below, because I kind of enjoy doing these kinds of videos, but, you know, I kind of need more ideas. So if you have any ideas or want a topic that you will want my opinion on or just discussed in general, then leave it in the comment section below. I'll look at it and I'll probably make a video on it if the topic interests me. It could be about anything. And yeah, okay, now that's it. I promise, I swear, trust and believe, this time I'm actually done. Stop talking right about. Also, tell me, you know, since this is my first time making a video like this, tell me what you guys think in the comments below too, and, you know, see if you tell me if you want more of these types of videos or not. You know, that the feedback will be super helpful. Okay, now again, like I said, like, comment, subscribe. Last time I'm talking, I swear, this time, I legitimately promise, I'm so serious, it's gonna end right about now.